Welcome back, everybody, in the very last bonus video of this series. In the previous bonus video, we created a slicer, and now we can use the slicer to select the period we want to look at the data, and the data will change accordingly. But there is one problem with it, and the problem is with the top 10 lists, because the top 10 lists are based on a pivot table, and we really need that because we have a lot of customers, so we really need the pivot table to summarize for us what are the top 10 customers, and the same for the products. But if I change the selection of the period, then it will look up additional data. You can see that the trend, the spark lines were changed, but it didn't refresh the pivot table. To do that, I need to go to data. But I should not select a picture. I should go to data, and then I say refresh all. And now on the background, it will also automatically refresh the tables. And we saw some changes over here. I don't like that. I would like to automate that. And there's no way to do that with a formula, but we can do it with VBA, and it's not that difficult. So. And because it's a bonus exercise, we should try to do that. So we need to go into the VBA editor, and we can do that with the key combination Alt F11. So here we are in the program environment of Excel. And here we see our VBA project with our worksheet. Now, what we want to do is that as soon as this field, this cell X1, as soon as that is changed, we want that the pivot tables are automatically refreshed. And we can do that by using an event. And it's an event that should be triggered by the sheet dashboard. Where is it? There we are, so we double click on it. Then I say it's a worksheet event. The first one is always not the one I want, because this is a selection change, meaning an event that will be triggered as soon as we click with the mouse somewhere on a cell, but we only want to have an event triggered if a value in a cell is changed, and therefore we need the change event. Meaning that this one we can delete. So what we see now is we have an event. So every time a cell is changed on the worksheet dashboard, this event is called and we will get a target. And the target is the cell or the range of cells that has been changed. So what we could do is we could create an if statement. If target dot and then the address equals X1, because that was our cell, then you should do something. And an if should always be closed with an end if. So every cell can be changed, but only if it is X1, then the pivot table should be changed. Now, to do that, the pivot tables are located on the sheet Customer Top 10 and Product Top 10. And what will make our life a little bit easier if we give the pivot table that we see over here a proper name. So let's do that, because normally it's called something like Pivot Table 1. But now we're going to say this is the pivot. Now I will just call it top 10 cust. So, and I will do the same for the product pivot table. With the exception that the name will be a bit different, top 10 prod. So now I have two named pivot tables, and that makes our coding a bit easier. And they're located on the sheets cust10 and prot10. So we go over here and we say we have the sheet cust top 10. And on that sheet we have a collection of pivot tables, or we at least could have a collection of pivot tables. And from that collection of pivot tables we want to have the top 10 cust. And from that specific pivot table we want to do a refresh of the table. And if we have that, we can copy it. And now we have to change it for the prot. So, and this should do it. So we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lines of codes, with the core only being 2 lines. Let's check if we didn't make any errors. We did. And that's correct, it should not be sheets, but it is a collection of sheets. Dus we need an S there. Check again. Yeah, no troubles, no error messages. Then I'm always very curious if it works, so I will put a breakpoint over here, so that I really see that it will go into this code. And actually I should put it over here. So we go to our dashboard. And now I'm going to change to 2016-12. And dang, it is in our code. We can see that the address is x1. And then I have an error over here. And I see it. So we will continue. And it did work. So let's remove the breakpoint. Let's go back and do a final test. So we're going to change it back to 2016-07. And now you see it, the system needs a little bit more time, but it did not only refresh all the data, but it did also refresh the Sparkline data. We have a small problem over here, but that's an error in my own file. In the file you can download, you won't have that problem. So that brings us to the end of this exercise. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see very nice dashboards from all of you. Thank you.